Hi, Jeff Rick here with theCUBE. We're on the ground at the San Jose Convention Center at the Intuit QuickBooks Connect 2015 show. About 5,000 people, second year of the show, want to come down and get a feel for what's going on. And I'm really excited to be joined by our next guest, Karen Peacock, the VP of Small Biz, Intuit QuickBooks. Welcome, Karen.
Thanks, Jeff. Very nice to meet you. Happy to be here.
Absolutely. So for the folks that haven't been to the show, kind of give an update. What's the show all about? Why did you guys decide to do this? And what's the vibe this year?
Yeah, so QuickBooks Connect is all about helping small businesses succeed and getting small businesses connected to the people and resources that they need to help them be successful. So it's also for accountants, help them find new small businesses, help them with productivity tools as they help small businesses, and it's about awesome developers. One of the things that we'll talk about in a minute is QuickBooks has really moved from being an individual application to being a global platform. So we have an awesome group of developers outside our team who created amazing applications and integrated programs. But at its heart, it's all about helping small businesses. It's all QuickBooks Connect. It's all about doing small businesses.
That's interesting because it's beyond just the simple software that you used to come in the mail every year. You got your updates when the tax laws changing. So you've been at Intuit for a while.
Yes, I've seen that transformation.
Yeah, I was going to say, share the story of how that changed, because that's really what it used to be. Everybody had it. You know, you got your update every year, but now you've got things in the cloud. Now we just talked to Avi about your developer program. I had no idea you guys had such an active developer program. So talk to the audience a little bit about that transformation. How did it come about? And where are you guys in that journey?
Real transformation for us. At our core, we've always had the same mission, maybe with slightly different words, but it's really all been about helping small businesses succeed. We believe that when small businesses thrive, we all do. And so we started with desktop software, you know, the CDs in the mail, as
right,
you said,
right,
CDs
right.
Going to the store. And then over the past kind of 5+ years, we've really transformed to being a business. And in particular, last year, we had more customers choose our online products, more new users go online than desktop, which is a real inflection point for us last year, and that's just accelerating for us. And at core, that's really because with an online product, you can do so much more. You can be able to access your information about your clients while you're on the road, while you're on a vacation, you can run payroll, and the kind of connections that you can make with other products are just so much more seamless. So that the collaboration anytime, anywhere, access in the cloud, just make it incredible. And the ability to quickly develop new offerings in an agile way has enabled us to move quickly and really develop great things for our clients.
Right, so yeah, because they accessible all the time, right? This little thing called mobile that suddenly is an increasingly important part of your portfolio.
You know, people used to say, no way can I ever imagine doing my accounting on a mobile phone. I was actually just meeting with a group of accountants yesterday, and one guy said, I swore I will never do accounting on a mobile device. Picked out his phone and was like, you know what I'm doing now? I'm classifying it, I'm reconciling, I'm doing this all on my phone, which is just a huge transformation.
Right. Well, I was going to say, what are some of the actual functions that you find people do? Because now it's an online app, you can see how people are using, what they do. What are some of the things they do on mobile? Because I'm sure a lot of people are like, I haven't even got my Bank of America on there yet.
Exactly.
I don't know that I'm doing my accounting. So what
I'll give
do
you a couple of good examples.
Yeah.
So one thing is, I'm driving out to my client's site. And I'm trying to remember, what was the last work exactly that I did for this client? And did Cooper pay me for that invoice? And so you can go there and say, they still owe me $200. So just before we talk, could you maybe pay me that $200 from the last time that we worked together? So that's a great example. Another thing you can do on your mobile device is be able to accept payment. So if you're on the road and say, you've got
you want that $200 from
exactly.
me.
You can just walk around. You can walk around and sell actually on a mobile device. Like run payroll off of your mobile. So I'm actually a customer. My husband's a small business owner, and we run payroll off of mobile phones. So it takes 2 minutes to run payroll.
So the other huge transformation when you go to a cloud-based business is your own interface development, your own ability to be agile. You're not just shipping it just once a year. How has that been kind of adopted inside of the company, and what's that enabled you to do that you just couldn't do before?
Yeah, so it is absolutely inspiring and transformational because you can have releases then on a weekly basis and as opposed to on an annual basis. So the pace of innovation has just skyrocketed. It enables us to get out product in the form of beta or Intuit Labs to customers really early to have them check it out so we can learn from them. Hey, I love these three things you did. Forgot about this one thing. Awesome. Let's build that up and get it out there to customers.
Yeah, it's interesting because you guys have always been really outbound in terms of getting feedback from customers. I remember all the time getting emails, hey, we'd love to have you come on down and watch you do your thing. Yeah, absolutely. So, but now this gives you a whole another level of insight into the way that people are actually using the applications.
And we can see what areas of the application people use more and figure out how to make that better and better. So things that take too long, things that are kind of slow flow, we work on speeding those things up. So based on what people are actually doing, we can make the product better.
Okay, so then the next shift gears is this whole kind of entrepreneurship focus. That you guys are really putting your money where your mouth is. It's not just a tool. But we just had Lindsay Lorraine on. You've got a contest. Somebody's going to win a Super Bowl ad. You've got a marketplace.
Can't say that word.
Oh, can't say it. The big game at Levi Stadium in February.
That's right.
With gold. And also, that's something I've never heard about. You've got actually a marketplace for financing for small business.
Yeah, so one of the things that we have realized is that the number one reason why small businesses fail is because of cash flow trapped. And that's probably no surprise. Some of the things that we can do to help cash flow is help you get paid, but also help you when you need it to get funding. And so what we've seen is historically a small business owner has really hard time filling out loan applications. So 100 plus different questions we ask you. You ever filled out a loan application?
Yes.
For anything?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Car, boat, house, all
the yes, of course. Yes. I love the ads on the radio now. They're like, just bring your paperwork from last year. You already did it, right?
Exactly. And so what we do is we take that 100 plus question process and simplify it down to one question. And how we do that is we take the data from QuickBooks Online and we bring that in and we use that to basically fill out your loan application for you. You can still review it if anything you want to take out or change it there, you can. And then what we've also seen is that most small businesses today go through all of this work and most get turned down. So two-thirds of small businesses who apply for a loan get turned down.
Why?
Oftentimes it's questions about their cash flow or not knowing enough about the business. And that's what we can just flip on its head. So we take rather than 100 questions, one click, and much more important than that, rather than two-thirds of people getting turned down, we can flip that on its head and we are now improving two-thirds of people who apply for a loan.
Because with the proper authorization, the lenders now can see a different level of detail than just the question, the answers on those questions.
The power of the data. You talk about big data out there.
Right,
this
right.
is a perfect example of data really working for you.
Yeah. And then the other huge shift that we just heard from Augie talking about the developer program.
Yes.
So I imagine, again, you must have some great stories of, you know, wait a minute, you know, we dictate our product roadmap. We've been building great software for a long time. What about a mind shift to actually open up to third-party developers? How did that go over? What
exactly.
was kind of that story?
You know, it's interesting because we even started that back in the desktop days, but it's really hard to have an open platform on the desktop because the integration is just so much easier on the cloud, technically. And the aha is we're really focused on this mission of helping small businesses succeed. That doesn't mean it's all just the work that we do. And our aha is actually it's work that we and those that we partner with do together. And so that's work that we do, working with accountants in partnership, working with